Hello, beautiful blockchain people. That's me again at CryptoSpine. This is my next cryptocurrency market overview. So let's start. Let's check the prices of the major cryptocurrencies according to the site of CoinGecko. And we see that the market continues to consolidate. Bitcoin is testing the level of $13,800 again. I want to say that yesterday I talked about Bitcoin. I outlined some very important key resistance level, psychological resistance level, and this is namely the level of $13,880, and now it is testing this level. And I want to say that in my view now we will see some kind of consolidation in the next couple of days. That's why probably the prices of the major cryptocurrencies after the price increase, they will probably continue to consolidate. And that's why today I won't analyze any price chart. Today I will talk a little bit about centralized and decentralized exchanges, and later I will mention some news relating to D2. So what I want to say is that yesterday or even the day before in the evening, I read this article with the following title: All in on decentralized finance. Why the days of centralized exchanges are numbered, according to the opinion of Changpeng Zhao, who is the CEO of Binance. And why I want to mention this article, why I decided to mention this article and to talk a little bit about it, is because, fellas, probably you have noticed that the price of HYPE is relatively low at the moment if compared to the prices it has, used to have, let's say, a couple of months ago. So now, for example, if you check Huobi Global, the price of HYPE is slightly above 10 cents. And this is extremely low level if compared to the levels a week ago even, or a month ago, or a quarter ago, and so on. So this is actually the chart. So you can see that this level is relatively low if compared to those levels. And I decided to power up. I decided to buy some HYPE recently and to power up, to buy some HYPE on centralized exchanges. And it turned out that I bought HYPE. I initiated a withdrawal to my account on HYPE, and I wanted to power up to take advantage of this, in my view, low levels. But what has happened so far? The crypto exchange that where I bought the HYPE, not Huobi, has started to proceed my withdrawal, and now it is pending. It's pending for about 10 days since then. And of course, it's unpleasant because I bought HYPE, I initiated withdrawal, and it is pending. And neither I can cancel this withdrawal, there is no button or option to cancel it to receive back the HYPE into the exchange. Of course, it is in the exchange to receive it into my account, to sell it at lower levels, to get some other crypto and to transfer it to other exchange or other place and buy their HYPE. It's not possible. Neither this is possible, nor I receive my HYPE. Of course, on a daily basis, I write tickers to their support. And what I receive almost every second day is when they send some belated answers to my ticker, to my issue. They say wait for 24 hours. Sometimes transactions on blockchains are recorded in a little bit longer time, so it needs up to 24 hours. Of course, the first time they sent this message to me was a kind of okay, but I initiated this transaction almost 10 days ago. Later, I wrote in the second ticker that 24 hours are gone, and now I still haven't received my HYPE. Please withdraw my funds or credit my account again, and I will sell it for some other crypto on your exchange. But they don't answer. And then I wait a couple of days. I write another ticket and ask them, please withdraw my funds. And automatically, probably some of those customer support fellas in their exchange, He just copy paste some answer and again they send to me, wait for 24 hours. There is no problem with this coin in our exchange. Wait for, and I see that this is really very unpleasant situation, because on a daily basis, I wait for my Hive, I write tickers, they copy paste some nonsense to me. In response, I answer, I have waited already, not 24 hours, but 7 days, then 8 days, then 9 days. Please withdraw my funds. And they sent again to me, wait for 24 hours. Sometimes the transaction needs 24 hours. So this is really a very unpleasant situation when the customer support doesn't care at all. They just copy paste something. I'm pretty sure they don't read what I write. I even sent screenshots to them. And of course, it's very unpleasant when you cannot withdraw your funds from an exchange. And this is the problem of these centralized exchanges. And I'm pretty sure that many cryptocurrency enthusiasts, they have encountered such issues. Because this is not the first time I see something like this. I am in the cryptocurrency market since, let's say, the middle or the first half of 2017. And I have witnessed so many issues like this, so many problems. Of course, I am in the financial markets since 2006. And I work with many brokerage companies. I had platforms, so I had problems for all those 14 years. Sometimes they happen, and sometimes you have to leave a broker because they don't want to solve your problem, and because they simply block your funds for some reasons they even don't explain to you, or they may even disappear. Of course, there are such kind of platforms, so I'm familiar with this. And I want to say, this is a very unpleasant thing in the decentralized exchanges, in the centralized exchanges. And that's why in the long run, centralized exchanges, they will be displaced by decentralized exchanges. So I do agree absolutely with the statement of CZ that the days of the centralized exchanges are numbered, because DeFi will finally displace them. And of course, fellas, I'm not pretty sure what will happen to my Hive, but I hope that this exchange someday will decide to send me this Hive before they disappear. Because in 2019, on a similar exchange, I had slight problem where I bought at that moment Steam and couldn't withdraw it, and I had to sell it for a price 3 times less than the market price. It was really very unpleasant, and I left this exchange, and it turned out that I left it just in time, because later they disappeared. So what I want to say is, fellas, this is about centralized and decentralized exchanges. Actually, we don't need those centralized exchanges, at least in my view. And now I will switch to another article that was published. Actually, this is an announcement by DTube, you know, this platform. This is the platform here of this DTube ecosystem, and they announced that they will list their DTube coin, or wrap DTube coin, on the decentralized exchange Uniswap. And I'm really very happy. Yesterday when I saw this announcement, I was really very happy, because as they said, as some of you may know, the popularity of decentralized exchanges is rapidly increasing. Uniswap is the current, the most popular one for decentralized finance. So, of course, we need such kind of decentralized services. And I'm really very happy that DTube has decided to list their token on a decentralized exchange such as Uniswap, instead of listing it on some centralized exchange where sooner or later people may face some unpleasant issues. And of course, fellas, that's it for today. This is really some tricky moment, this, let's say, competition between centralized and decentralized exchanges. Just a short example, a small example. So this is the price on Huobi of Hive, 10 cents 0.10. on Binance it is almost 16 or 70% higher, 11 cents 0.79. And I want to say that, of course, there is huge difference, 15% or 16%. This is because you cannot withdraw from Hive, from Huobi, your Hive as well. And you cannot withdraw, but you can withdraw from Binance. They launch the withdrawal process really in time, to be honest, at least in my view. And that's why the price of Hive is much higher on Binance. And what I want to say is, for example, Hobby, it's really also very unpleasant because they closed the withdrawal and deposit possibility or functionality to deposit or and to withdraw Hive in the middle of September, and now is the beginning of November. It is month and a half since people haven't been able to withdraw their Hive from Hobby, or they have to sell it with solid discount. And that's why the price is declining significantly in Hobby. And I want to say that I choose an exchange where the withdrawal and deposit functionality are probably working, because you can initiate a withdrawal, you can deposit, but they block it once you click on deposit and later. So at least Hobby, they highlight this button, withdrawal and deposit, that they are not working. So actually you cannot even initiate a process to withdraw or deposit a cryptocurrency. But what I want to say, it's really very unpleasant, because I asked them their support, fellas that work in the support department of Hobby Global, when they will launch the withdrawal or reopen the withdrawal and deposit process. And they said that because of hard fork, because of the hard fork 24 or something like this, they have maintenance. Sorry, fellas, but the hard fork 2 plays in the first half of October, and all exchanges, other small exchanges, most of them launch this functionality again. And this leading exchange that holds a lot of Hive still doesn't let users withdraw their Hive. That's why I want to say this is really very unpleasant. This is really very unpleasant, because this is a big exchange and they have a lot of Hive. You can check their wallet. So it has a solid negative impact, at least in my view, on the price of Hive, on the price that we see in the exchanges. But this is just my point of view. It's up to you. But I have decided to be really very careful with all those centralized exchanges, and will try to reduce the activities, my activities on centralized exchanges. So that's it for today, fellas. Thank you for watching this video. I wish you a wonderful day. Good luck in the financial markets, and hope to see you in the next one. It was me again at CryptoSpark.